Hey everyone, this is Nick, and today I wanted to share a really quick trick on something that I have been working on in terms of my guest experience dashboard. So you might have many charts like this if you are responsible for monitoring trends or tracking trends in your visitor experience. So right here, I just have a chart that, a traditional column chart that shows visitors who reported having an extra special experience during their visit to the museum. So it's just the percentage of visitors who selected this on our guest experience survey, and this is our annual number from 2020 all the way through the current year, 2022. And then I also have my monthly data, January through December for this year, the current year, 2022. And I only have January, February, and March data so far. So the rest of the months are still yet to go. Now, there's no problem in visualizing your data in a tracking chart like this. It's totally perfect and it looks great. But the thing is, you might have a lot of these types of tracking charts to report. And so it can be kind of monotonous to do the same column chart or bar chart over and over and over again. So maybe you can strategically switch up the chart type by maybe changing something like this to an area chart. Now, an area chart will serve the exact same purpose. It's just basically like a line chart, but with the filled in area underneath. And so it kind of looks a little bit different. It's something that maybe your audience doesn't quite expect. Maybe it's a little attention grabbing, and that's what we want from our audience. The problem with area charts is when you insert them into PowerPoint, they will always give you these diagonal sections, these diagonal lines that go from the data point all the way down to the zero axis. Now, in this case, we have gaps in between our time. We want to show the gap between our annual data and our monthly data, and the gap really doesn't mean anything. It's just a separator in our chart. So what we need to do is we need to get rid of those kind of triangles or those diagonal sections in the chart so that we have these straight line cliffs on our area chart. This way, you can see a nice clean break between the end where your data stops and where your data has yet to be filled in. And so we can actually do this inside of Excel and PowerPoint in just the click of a button. You don't need any behind the scenes hacking to do this. So this is how we're gonna do it. I'm gonna flip over to the computer here. I'm gonna show you how to do this. Just select your chart that you've inserted in your PowerPoint slide. Go up to the chart design tab on the ribbon and then select data. This is going to open your source data and the select data source menu. Go ahead and click on hidden and empty cells. Now you can see it's defaulted to zero, but we want to change it to gaps. So show empty cells as gaps. We're going to click OK. Click OK one more time, and you will see these beautiful cliffs on your area chart. Doesn't that look great? So this is a really great trick to use if you are reporting these data monthly or quarterly, some other time interval where you want to show people that you're going to be having that data in the future, but you just don't have it today and you're going to update it as time goes on. So this is a really great trick to use. I hope you do it. I hope that you like this video and also subscribe to my channel. Just click the subscribe button. You can actually get a notification into your YouTube app if you hit the bell next to the subscribe button. And I would really appreciate that. So I hope you have a great day, and I will see you next time.